My name is Gabby Bailato. I'm a solutions marketing engineer here with Keysight Technologies. Today I will show you how to capture and characterize a pulsed radar signal. Electronic warfare can be difficult because of the high pulse density environments and complex signals. And many times, there are varying PRIs, pulse widths, and amplitudes that you would want to capture. Take, for example, this pulsed radar signal centered at 4 GHz. Let's change the measurement time and sample rate to better optimize the measurement. We'll also change the detection threshold to ensure that we are capturing and analyzing all of the pulses. Lastly, let's single the measurement so we can get one full capture. On the top of our screen, we have the time domain view. This gives us a visualization of our signal under test. We can see things like amplitude variation and also that there are different PRIs in between pulses. The pulse table below shows the calculated measurements. We can see things such as modulation on pulse, amplitude parameters such as pulse level, overshoot, and ripple, timing parameters like width, PRI, and duty cycle, and frequency and phase parameters. This table can be exported in the format shown or as a Keysight PDW format, which can be used for generating signals with an agile signal generator. Now that we've had an overview of the pulse measurements, let's take a closer look at what's going on in the pulse table. We can see here that there are different modulation on pulses, amplitudes, and pulse widths interleaved together. This can come from an environment with multiple radar or emitter modes. Currently, the PRI is calculated between each pulse. However, you may want to validate that it's correct between similar pulse types rather than pulse to pulse. To do this, we can use the pulse sorter to only make measurements on specific pulses. Analysis can be done by sorting them by frequency, amplitude, or modulation. From the pulse table, we know that there are some frequency modulated pulses. Let's use that as a sorting parameter. Now we can see that the analyzer has highlighted all of the linear frequency modulated pulses in green. Notice the PRI has now been updated, showing us that there is a 450 microsecond PRI between each LFM pulse. As shown today, quick, efficient electronic warfare measurements can be done with Keysight's UXA and N9037C pulse analysis application to capture and characterize your complex signals, ensuring your system is ready for deployment. For more information, please visit keysight.com or contact your local Keysight representative. Thanks for listening.